You're in for a real treat. This episode of The Hypocrite Twins is based on the book Treacherous Alliance by Trita Parsi, which has interviews with many Israeli, American, and Iranian government officials who spill the embarrassing truth on their dealings with each other. Let's dive in.
I have traveled to the planet Earth to understand the concept you call war. Unfortunately, the only human body I could inhabit is a Swedish tranny pole dancer.
You gotta be kidding me. That chick's a tranny? Like, operation with a penis? She doesn't look like it. I guess what better way to start off a video series on Iran's nuclear program? Cause you never know what surprises they're hiding. But I personally don't want to be the one to do the inspections. You idiot, that's transgender. This is transvestite. It's just a dude wearing girls' clothes. I don't care about gender pronouns. I'm only looking it up to rag on you. Looking up when someone has a vagina is a bad time to use the phrase, rag on you.
This is not funny. I seek to create world peace on Earth, but I'm confused why there's fighting to begin with. I looked at the map, and Iran is 1,000 miles from Jerusalem. If they don't claim Israeli land, why is there tension with Israel?
Okay, so to give this fighting some context, you need to understand that there's two main types of Muslims, Sunnis and Shiites, which are fighting each other. Right, Iran is Shiite, which, like a tranny, from looking at it, you can't tell it's pronounced with a she. And the rest of the Middle East is Sunni, including Egypt, Saudi Arabia, Iraq, Saddam Hussein, and even the Palestinian groups like Hamas. It's pronounced Sunni. I guess what better way to scare off the Jews than a prefix that sounds like a lawsuit?
Okay, so if Sunnis and Shiites are fighting, and Iran is Shiite, and Palestinians, like Hamas, are Sunni, why does Iran support the Palestinians?
The answer to that is a complex story, which actually starts out with Israel and Iran being secret best friends during the Iran-Iraq War, which is a classic example of Sunni-Shiite conflict. Right, the Iran-Iraq War is one of the bloodiest conflicts that nobody in America gives a shit about, because it's between two of America's enemies. You never hear a college protester say, "Dude, I'm protesting to save the rainforest. And I'm protesting for animals' rights. This pug was not given a proper manicure. And I'm protesting to save Saddam Hussein and the Ayatollah's mercenaries. I wanted to fight, but they wouldn't recruit me because of my allergies." Here's the wild part. Israel sold Iran weapons that were mostly American-made as part of the Iran-Contra scandal. You never hear this mentioned when we talk about Donald Trump pulling out of the Iran deal. Like, hey, where'd they get missiles to begin with? Not a word out of Trump on this. Although he'd probably say, well, they were American missiles. That helps the trade balance. We should send Israel to sell them to China.
This sounds like a dumb strategy, that Israel supplied weapons to Iran. Why did they do this?
Well, according to David Kimcha, former head of the Israeli Foreign Ministry,
stopping Saddam was paramount, and if that meant going along with the request for arms by the Iranians, and that could prevent an Iraqi victory, so be it.
Well, at the time, Iraq was the bigger threat, and they were closer. And let's be honest, Saddam Hussein is way scarier than the Ayatollah, because the Ayatollah at least pretends to be religious. Think about it this way. The Palestinians are fighting because they say it's their homeland. Iran is fighting because they say it's the Holy Land. Saddam is fighting just because it's land. That's how crazy he is. To him, it's just regular desert, and he'll still kill you for it. Saddam Hussein and Israel are both tyrants the United States armed. The only difference is Saddam didn't have weapons of mass destruction.
I am confused about both sides being armed. Can you explain this?
The West purposely armed both sides because they wanted them to bleed each other out. America only tolerated Saddam because they wanted to get rid of the new Iranian regime. Iran just had a revolution, throwing out the pro-Western friendly leader and replacing him with the Ayatollah. At the time, America had so many puppet dictators, they should have made Secretary of State Jim Henson. You think that the Ayatollah is good for America? You retarded faggot! That is such mean hate speech. You are so rotten for using it. Plus, retarded faggot is not even a good insult. Because if I'm that dumb, how do you know I'm really gay? Maybe I married the dude because I thought it was a chick, just like you and the alien tranny. Do you not see the hypocrisy in criticizing my speech while defending Iran when they stone gaze to death? So it's okay as long as you're holding a rock. They beat my head with a boulder for sucking dick in the alley. But at least it's not right-wing hate speech, right? I mean, have you seen Trump's tweets? And so, the next time you're in Iran and you get caught sleeping with a man, you can tell the Ayatollah at your trial what the liberal told me. Stone the retarded faggot. Allah Akbar. Allah la 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 la. Wait. I didn't know it was a tranny. I'm just regular retarded.
Putting religious difference aside, why is America arming Iran then if they wanted to defeat them for rebelling against American puppets?
Hezbollah had captured American hostages in Lebanon. Ronald Reagan's administration enabled Israel to sell weapons to Iran if in return they would convince Hezbollah to release the American hostages. Well, that's what the Reagan administration said happened, but an investigation found that the arms sales began in 1981, while as the hostages weren't taken till 1982. So I guess Israel sold Iran weapons in case they might take hostages. Hey, you never know, right? Israel sold us this missile if we'll release the hostages. Oh shit, we gotta get some hostages or we'll have to give it back.
Wow, that's ridiculous. Did it work?
Eventually, but at first they had problems.
After two arms shipments, only one American hostage had been released. This was partly the result of an embarrassing Israeli mistake. Not only had they shipped the wrong missiles, but the ones they had sent had the Star of David stamped on them.
This shit is fucking ridiculous. Israel accidentally sent Iran missiles with the Star of David on them. Now who's a retarded faggot? Iran was furious, but they should have been ecstatic. Because if America thought that it was Israel, they'd let any war crimes go.
So I assume that Israel does not steal arm Iran?
That's correct. Once the Iran-Iraq war ended, so did the secret Israeli-Iran friendship. Me and the liberal disagree over who's to blame for this, as well as we disagree over what preventative actions Western governments should take. Come on, give me my hat back. I'm a liberal! You can trust my government to protect you from Iran's terrorism. Okay, so in our previous video, we discussed how Israel's prime minister wanted to make peace with the Palestinians through the Oslo agreements. However, if he made peace with them, it meant two things. First, Israel would have to give up land, and secondly, they would lose clout with the Americans as a military ally and no longer need so much American money. I used to be part of the boycott, divest, and sanction movement, but now that Israel made peace with Palestine, I'm protesting that there aren't enough kosher gluten-free options at the bakery. So Israel needed a new enemy to justify this continued security. Basically, America said, you gotta make peace with the Palestinians. And Israel replied, sure, right after we bomb Iran. Just because Israel sold Iran weapons to defeat Saddam Hussein doesn't mean they owe them friendship once the war is over. Liberals have this sense of entitlement. Should Israel have to pay for the Ayatollah student loans? Bernie Sanders would have you think so, even if the Ayatollah majored in sociology and art.
So at first Israel armed Iran. Now they thought they were a threat. What changed?
Nothing changed. There was no new action from Iran.
Iran hadn't changed. Everyone else had. Iran was more prominent on the Israeli radar, not because it had become more antagonistic toward Israel, but because all previous threats had more or less evaporated. There were simply no other conventional military threats left.
After the Iran-Iraq War, more than a million Iranians died, and they were weaker now than ever before. But suddenly, as American pressure to make peace with the Palestinians built up, Israel cried out, "Death is at our doorstep!"
Death is at our doorstep, Yitzhak Rabin concluded, even though only a few years earlier, he'd called Iran a strategic ally.
Who's dead at the doorstep? Is it the million Iranians that Saddam Hussein used chemical weapons on that he bought from America? In that case, America's reaction should have been, "Death is at our doorstep! Oh shit! Let's pop open the champagne! We crippled Iran!"
The feeling that the Perez-Rabin government exaggerated the Iranian threat was widespread inside the Clinton administration.
Please don't cut off my defense money. Iran has missiles.
Yeah, what kind of missiles is that? Star of David missiles? You're so retarded, you could suck a dick in Iran and the Ayatollah would pardon you.
Here's the thing, you say there was no new action from Iran. And that's true, because the Ayatollah was calling for the end of Israel the entire time. So your main argument is, it's okay, he's a liar. How is this any different than normal progressive arguments?
Sir, the progressive army is about to invade.
Liberals can't keep their promises.
But they're loading up the warheads now.
Yeah, and I'm still waiting for this Obamacare website to load. So while the Ayatollah's rhetoric didn't change, what changed is previously they were busy fighting Saddam Hussein. Once the Iran-Iraq war was over, Iran was able to act on the threats that previously they were making. You follow?
I still don't understand why Shiite Iran supports Sunni Palestinians.
To understand that concept, you need to first realize that the United States started putting puppet dictators in most of the Sunni Arab world. You know they must be easy to herd. When their names Mubarak, Fahad. Because Sunni Arab leaders were cooperating with America, Iran took it as an opportunity to start talking shit. I mean, hey, if there's no crying baby on the airplane, I might as well start bawling, right? Right, since Iran called out Sunni Arab leaders for allowing Israel to exist, Iran could be viewed as the real Islamic State. Shiite Iran helps Sunni Palestinians to hurt the Sunni governments that it fights with.
Iran appealed to the Arab street to undermine pro-Western governments from below by making them look soft on Israel. The aim was to create a situation in which the Israelis couldn't reach the deal, explained an Iranian political figure. Because the more messy the situation, the better off we are, because it wins us time.
Attention, Muslim world. Iran is the real Islamic State because we will aid you in freeing Jerusalem from Western imperialism.
Allah Akbar!
Allah la 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 la!
Attention, Muslim world. Saudi Arabia is the real, genuine Islamic State. Yes, we're one of the biggest buyers of US treasuries, of which one of the biggest foreign aid recipients is Israel. But when we went to list our IPO for oil on the New York Stock Exchange, we're making sure that most of the lawyers and bankers that help us aren't Jewish. Most of them. So we're not some Slim Shady. Will the real Islamic State please stand up? Please stand up. I agree. Saudi Arabia and OPEC selling oil in US dollars and buying treasuries is like Eminem's Slim Shady, because it makes you go, why are all these minorities buying the white man's shit? The irony of all of this is during the period of time when Iran had the most anti-Israel rhetoric, is during the period when they had the least action.
In spite of his anti-Israel rhetoric, Khomeini declined against a request to send Iranian F-14s to aid the Syrian Air Force against Israel in the ongoing fighting in Lebanon, indicating yet again that Iran did not intend to take an active role on the Arab side against Israel beyond its verbal condemnations of the Jewish state.
So Iran's rhetoric is a bunch of bullshit, just like Western politicians. Who would have thought that Iran and Israel had so much in common? They both need to pretend to give a fuck about Palestinians. While it's true that Iran originally was just mouthing off, they went on later to fund Hamas and Hezbollah, which I'm thinking wasn't good for world peace. If only Iran spent the money on its own domestic citizens that it does foreign terrorists. In fact, if I were a local Iranian, I just lie and say I'm a foreign terrorist. I need money to feed my starving infant. We don't give food stamps to the poor. Go die in a ditch. I'm raising my infant to resist Israel. Oh, in that case, take the shirt off my back. You can have the money from my pocket and have sex with my wife. Who, by the way, is in that ditch I mentioned earlier. But surely we'll figure this all out in part two.
In the next episode, we'll analyze if Iran really wants to destroy Israel, or is the rhetoric a lie?
To cover both sides, I often wear outfits that I disagree with. So I'm a tranny politician. Not to piss off transgenders, though. As I told you earlier, if you only change outfits, you're a transvestite politician. Oh no, I got the operation. Now that I have a pussy,
I'm a liberal. Are you saying that because you think my side's soft, or you're worried Donald Trump might grab it? Well, you know how I'd like it licked. Allah Akbar.